Looking for anything in particular. Let's see, equip. Basic armor. Oh, I didn't even see the probably shouldn't have done that. But you can combine things together. Where does it say? There we go. Some more HP would be good. Some more magic attack. Okay. Damn. Okay, skills. Damn it. Suck. There we go. Nah, I don't think I need to go down there. What is in here? What could this be? Ho ho. Two true children of the Solstice have come for their rite of passage by also sends one who does not belong here. Is he brave or foolish? Let's find out. Welcome, young adventurers, to this sacred pond. Nice to meet you, Elder Mist. My name is Garl. My, what a gregarious one you are. Enthusiasm is certainly welcome in this place of meditation, but its rites are not meant for the common folk. Children of the Solstice, step forward. Seems you show great potential. Have you weaved your will into celestial fabrics? We have, Elder Mist, and come closer and let them be imbued by the sacred pond's magic. A tremendous resonance. Wear them with purpose, for they will augment your innate magic. You shall henceforth have light in the darkest places and protection against the minions of the Fleshmancer. I don't feel any different. Yeah, me neither. Rest assured, the ability to use magic without using magic has not taken root in you, indeed. What does that even mean? And how does it work? It arises from need. In the many battles that await you, victory will often demand the use of more offensive magic than one can sustain through spells alone. That is why attunement to live mana is paramount. Live mana? It allows your attacks to draw from the magic bestowed upon you at birth. And judging by the resonance you create, this power should even extend to your traveling companions. You are ready. Live mana will start manifesting for you the next time you enter battle. Are you ready for your final test? I want to go with them, please. Interesting, you are the first of the common folk to ever make such a request. No doubt limited when it comes to combat, but the warmth of his heart, could he bring it back? Perhaps we should try to find out. I will allow it. All right. Consider it a test of your ability to act as a companion to Solstice warriors. Then close your eyes and take a deep breath. Welcome to the Elder Mist Trials. To pass this final test, you must bring three big relics together. By completing their associated challenges, the monsters that will try to stop you are immune to physical attacks and the use of offensive spells is prohibited. How then? That is why you must use magic without using magic. Live mana can boost your battle actions with a portion of your magic attack. Embrace this power and your training will be complete. The trials await. Should you wish to return for a while, simply close your eyes and concentrate next to where you just appeared. Godspeed. That attack did nothing. A spell would probably do it, but we can't use them here. Guess that's the part where using magic without magic comes in. Could be, I feel kind of power towards them. Yeah, I feel it too. Let's try something. Whoa. It worked. How does it feel? Like power. So if I attack, it should do magic damage, right? Up to three boosting charges can be stacked, each adding a portion of your character's magic attack stat to their next action to increase its power. In the case of regular attacks, the character's innate magic damage type, if they have one, is also added on top of their weapon's damage type. Whether you are dealing with an intricate lock pattern, need to make your next healing spell really count, or just want to deal more damage, remember to boost. Basic salad, I can Okay. I need to bring three big relics back together. Equip basic armor. Okay, I see. It's a puzzle. I'm good at puzzles. Okay. To get this artifact piece, you will need to answer three questions correctly. Let's see how well you learned. Of these two actions, which one regenerates attacking? What is the name of the school you went to? Zenith. One very important Solstice warrior duty is to destroy dwellers who become vulnerable during which the eclipse. Gotta get that chest. Found the shiny pearl. Oh my gosh. That was easy. Yeah, I don't like that. This is our last chance to prepare. Do you feel ready? Wait. The young adventurers have finished the preparations. I see you understand the power of live mana, but can you master it? We shall see. The use of spells is now allowed again. Face me, children of the solstice. Okay, so... you I... Bro, there's no way you can defeat that. How do you defeat that? spot. Kill them. How formidable. A bright future awaits you indeed. Zale, Valere, I name you Solstice Warriors. I have consulted the mists of time during your trials. When you are ready to leave this place, find me back at the sacred pond and I will tell you of your respective prophecies. Then you will be sent out into the world. Don't take too long though. Where did I need to go? To return, right? The lake. The time has come to begin your journey. Morning, but it's the middle of the night. Yes, I suppose your friends should address that. Address what? Bring us the dawn. We can do that? All it takes is for you to stand on a celestial rune. And then what? Something inside of you knows already. Right this way. Now concentrate and bring us the dawn. How did you do that? That's the coolest thing I've ever seen. That part is always easier by simply going for it. Now, in your travels, you will sometimes find mechanisms and seals powered by magical runes that react to the time of day. They were put into place by Solstice Warriors who came before you. Some conceal artifacts meant to help future members of the order such as yourselves, while others seal away evils that were too powerful to confront. Whether or not to look for these artifacts and challenges will be entirely up to you. Now your journey can begin. Come and meet me beyond this chasm. How do we get across? By using your powers, of course. Meet me on the other side, and as a farewell gift, I will share with you what I could read in the mists of time. Try using the crystal to charge the smaller rune on the ground above. Nice. That's cool. That's a cool mechanic right there. Are you ready to be sent out into the world? Let us see you often, but first your prophecies. I will speak them to your minds directly, for they are yours and yours alone. Zale, step forward. In order to reach your full potential, you will first need to stare at the night inside of you. Thank you, Elder Mist. When the time comes, you will be the one to create paths on water. You must be mindful of your limitations during this journey. Carl, this is not a conversation. Oh, my bad. Carry on. The mists are unclear in your case, but it appears your heart might be warm enough to soothe a long, tormented soul. You have now learned everything I could teach you. I am sending you to Sleeper Island, where you are fated to meet a crew bound for adventure. Make friends with them, and they shall help you reach Wraith Island in time for the next eclipse. To activate this giant, give it the name Exodal to be sent to Sleeper Island. To return here, simply go to Exodal and speak this one's name, which is... Oh. Well, I suppose we won't be seeing each other for a while. Bro, he just yeeted us. And so it was that Zale and Valere were sent off to begin their journey, with their best friend the warrior cook in tow. In their quest to get to Wraith Island in time for the eclipse, they would soon come to grips with two very powerful wizards, one by anger beset, the other of life Barafet. Solstice Mage Ring. Party members recover 1 MP when block. Okay, so that was lock breaking. A rainbow conch. Might interest a collector. That's pretty cool.